Michael, welcome back to our office. Last 4 months you was in Canada.
Yes, sir.
Just for the benefit of my future Michael, just give me your impressions of the life in Canada, and particularly I would like to know what kind of preparation you have made before you land in Canada. Okay?
Definitely.
Please, can you speak louder?
Yes, sir. Obviously, if you all are preparing to go to Canada, please, 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 as a homework, watch all of Sir's videos possible. He has taken very much effort, a lot of effort in creating these videos with every immigrant possible, and also his experiences back in Canada that he has with regards to where to immigrate, which province to land in. Do not have confusions with that. Go to what Sir suggests you. And obviously make your decision based on those inputs and those suggestions that he's given. Obviously, since we already decided that we would be landing in Ontario, the first hurdle that I would suggest is that look for accommodation before you land there, for which you will need to first manage your timing or change your timing that you live in India to the timing that would be the Canadians live with regards to. And register yourself on kijiji.com and search for accommodations there. My criteria for searching the accommodation was the immigrant and the Canadian ratio of the population that is in that particular area or that province. Then also the crime rate in that particular province that I would want to stay. I do not want to be
away. All this information is readily available. You
yes.
Just dig deeper.
Exactly. And all yes. And I did not want to be away from downtown Toronto also, and not be very far also, that if I have to come to Toronto downtown, I'll take too much time. So somewhere in between, I kind of zeroed in on places like Whitby, Richmond Hill, Markham and Newmarket, which are peaceful and good enough to live in. And once you register yourself in Kijiji, the filter would definitely have how much you expect to pay as your rent, because getting an accommodation or at a relative space is good, but best is to be independent right from the beginning so that you know how much your expenses would be. And then I would suggest that before you go there, also have a multi-currency card. And we both of us did a homework on that, which multi-currency card is the best for us. And load that multi-currency card with enough amount and then go there, because that helps a lot. Also carry some money in cash. Do not just rely totally on the multi-currency card.
Right.
And that should suffice your need.
Another thing I would like to ask you, that is, in Ontario region, almost 3 months you will not be getting a health card.
Yes.
So sometimes it is prudent to have an health insurance for this period if something happens.
Yes.
Because Canadian health charges are too high.
Yes.
That is one idea.
Yes.
Another thing is about driving license.
Yes.
Exactly. You can highlight that thing
yes.
also.
So, with regards to that, as Sir mentioned, the health card will not come unless and until you have stayed there 3 months. And to register for the health card, you need two identity proofs. One can be sorted with your passport. The other one has to have a registered Canadian address on it. So for which, as soon as you come, you apply for your driving license. Your G1 driving license is just an online test which you give on computer. Once you give that, you will get at least the G1.
And about this G1, there are plenty of resources about
yes.
this online preparation.
Exactly.
If you do some homework,
yes.
it will be
PDF.
Easier for you
yes.
to clear that exam.
Yes.
That is again very important.
There is a PDF which is given by the government.
Exactly.
So
yeah.
if Ontario you, when you are searching Ontario's driving license .pdf, you will get that file definitely.
Right.
Go through that and one part is of common sense test and one part is the sign test.
Right.
Sign test you will clear easily, but the common sense test you will not. So just do some more. Even if you fail, don't hesitate to give it again. Immediately you can give it again and you will get the opportunity.
And be prepared with that Indian IPO office letter.
Yes. The driving license extract that other videos talk about did not actually work for me. They accepted, they want a letter on the letterhead proper mentioning my name, that this individual has been issued a driving license for so and so time and has been driving without any without any flaws or without any defects in his driving for so and so years. If I would have had that, I would have had a G license by now, but then I have a G2 and my wife has a G1 that served as the identity proof for our health cards. You register that, you will give you, they'll give you a temporary registration number or a letter for any medical emergencies. But the actual health card will come after 3 months only. So within the 3 months span, if you fall sick also, that provisional letter that they've given to you will work with the doctor.
That's really good. That's the piece of information. But that's it. You should be prepared for the driving license also.
Exactly.
Another address is absolutely important.
Absolutely.
Or you can ask to take a private health insurance for the 3 months.
Which will
it depends.
Cost.
Which we asked when we enquired, they said if you both are healthy and you are in summer, don't go further. It's a waste of money. But definitely if it is winter, and if you have dependent children, definitely do that. Don't hesitate to.
So these are the some general preparation which you should be making, particularly from getting a good accommodation, particularly from getting a driving license, and again applying for this health insurance. We are focusing on these three issues also. Then in next of our videos, we'll be talking about how to look for a job. That's all important thing, $1 billion question. Thank you for listening.